Hi, I'm Elsie. Welcome to River of Life Ministry. The Holy Spirit visits here all the time, and you will be blessed because we are every week, all the time.
See, the thing is sometimes we forget when we're in the midst of a battle. We're going to have one more song, and it's going to be live. But I just want to talk to you about this song. Sometimes we're in the midst of a battle, and we forget that He's faithful. Because what happens is we get into our feelings. And sometimes in the midst of a battle, our feelings can be controlling us when it has to be the Spirit of the living God that's inside of each and every one of us, because He is faithful. He will never leave us. He'll never forsake us. He's the great I Am, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and there's none like Him. And the plan that He has for you is good. The plan that He has for you is good. So I want you to think about that for just a moment. And I know that God has brought some of you here today just to renew your faith. But also He's brought you here to put hope in you, a hope that maybe you haven't had, or a hope that you had. And the Word says that hope deferred, if it gets deferred, it makes the heart grow sick, and we start to be discouraged. And that discouragement robs our joy. And I'm not saying, you know, that we don't have a moment of that, but it's when we yield to it and we think about it and we meditate on the discouragement, then it robs our joy. And that's what the enemy is after. But great is His faithfulness. Amen. Great is His faithfulness. It never ends. It doesn't stop. It's not because of what you do, but it's just because of who you are. Right. And if you've received Christ as your Lord and Savior, you belong to Him. And you are covered by His blessing. You are covered by His Word. You are covered by Him, His love, so that when you stand before the great white throne someday in that day of judgment, and the enemy of your soul comes forth and just spits out the things that maybe you've done or places you've been, Jesus steps up and says, you know what? Her sins are forgiven.
Right.
His sins are forgiven. And they're covered by the blood of the Lamb. I am the gift to the world. And they've received me. Hands off. Because I am the great I Am. So hang on to Jesus. Hang on to that hope. Hang on. He's there. Hang on.
Let the King
In the place of God, because that's who He is. Amen. And when the night is holding on to me, love. Today, I'm going to go to song lyrics before I go to the word because I use song lyrics a lot. I don't. God started doing this about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and at first it was really weird for me because I wasn't real comfortable with it because it's not opening my Bible. But there's so much word in the in lyrics if you're singing the right music. If you're not, then you need to get rid of them lyrics and bring new lyrics in. Amen? So there's this song that's called, Oh Lord, You're Beautiful. And you know, part of worship and part of relationship is understanding that we are the beloved of God, but yet He is the beloved of us. And sometimes we don't understand that relationship with God because we can't always touch Him. You know, we don't always see Him, but you do see Him if you look for Him. You see Him working in and through people. You hear Him working through people. You know, sometimes I like this because... This preacher guy, I heard him talking about people that are crying out to God, crying out to God, crying out to God. And Israel was crying out to God when they were in bondage to the Egyptians for 400 years, but they were just crying out to God and they were waiting to hear from God. Well, God was hearing their cries and God was talking to Moses, and Moses did not want to come to Egypt because he killed somebody, and Moses didn't have the confidence to go alone. God sent Aaron to walk with him. But I want you to know that sometimes when we're crying out to God and we're waiting to hear God, when God is already speaking to you through me or somebody else, that's God. Hello. And sometimes I've had to tell people, they're like, but I'm waiting to hear from God. I haven't heard from God. I said, you are right now. This is God working through me for your life. You know, I shouldn't have to tell you that, but sometimes you have to be told that because we think that we're the only ones that hear from God and that He's only going to speak to us. That's not true. He uses His people all over the place. It doesn't matter if you got saved yesterday. God's going to start using you now. On the spot, you're ready to rock and roll. Amen? And it doesn't matter if you've been a Christian for 50 years. God will use you. But if you stop and you get into pride and you decide, well, listen, I'm the only one that can hear God. You're a child. You just got saved. What do you know? But if you stay humble and you just listen to God and you get past maybe a little pride that maybe they have, or maybe just a little bit of personality that rubs you the wrong way, and you look for God in it, you're going to find God, right? Because He is on the move, right? So anyways, I love God. I love what He's doing. And sometimes when I sing these songs and this song starts out, oh Lord, You're beautiful. You are beautiful. You're beautiful. And sometimes we look for beauty to be in the appearance of a person. So it's hard for us to make our minds go deeper than that and go away from the beauty of a person and step into the beauty of love, the beauty of acceptance, the beauty of what love really is. It's beautiful. It's not what we look like. It's not even what Jesus looks like. It's not what God looks like. It's about who He is. He is a beautiful. Who else could accept somebody like me and be okay with me? Why wouldn't I think that His love is beautiful? Why wouldn't I accept that, right? And so we have to be transformed in our minds when we sing worship and we sing songs, you know, that, wow, we're talking about not the exterior beauty of a person, but the internal glory of God. And it's beautiful because it's just poured out over every one of us through the birth of Jesus Christ, through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. His beauty brought us to life. Now, He was pretty beat up, tore up on the cross. That was not a beautiful thing to look at. But the motive behind the sacrifice is beautiful. It's beautiful. The motive behind the birth of God is beautiful. The birth of Jesus is beautiful. He came here to die that we could be saved, that we could go to heaven, that we could walk into eternal beauty, eternal peace with God. Amen? Yeah. Emmanuel means God with us. Mm-hmm. God with us. Okay, so the first line is, oh Lord, You're beautiful. Your face is all I seek. And so sometimes faith can get me kittywampus because I'm looking for the face of God. But I want you to understand that when we're seeking his face, it's really his presence. It's really just him. It's just all that you are. And I want you to know that God says, if you seek me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart in the word of God, it says you will find me. You will find me. Not maybe, but you will. Because he's faithful, just like that song that we were singing. And I want you to know that he is a mountain mover. And if you are struggling, go back to a mountain that he's already moved to you for you and meditate on his goodness. Because that mountain that's before you is not any bigger or any stronger than the mountain he's already moved through for you.
That's right.
Amen. Yeah. So I want you to understand that, oh Lord, you're beautiful. We're saying this to God. This is a worship song. Oh Lord, you are beautiful. But yet at the same time, it is a communion song. The communion of the Spirit of the living God and the communion of the Spirit of Joyce Newman coming together and being in communion and worship and love. Amen. Hallelujah. Why can that happen? Because Joyce is just a person. Because I am a spirit in a body with a soul, but the spirit inside of me is holy.
Yes.
My soul has still got some issues. But the Spirit of the living God is holy, and he will not let me get away with continual sin in my life.
Right.
He will convict me. I'm not full of guilt and condemnation, but I start to feel bad. I start to be like, God, this isn't how I want to be, and I know that I'm better. That's not who I am. That's what I've done, but that's not who I am. God, this is who I am, and I start to focus on who I am. And who I am is because of who he is. Greater is he that lives in me than he that lives in the world, right? The flesh is in the world. So, oh Lord, you're beautiful. Your face, your presence, you're all that I seek. I just want you. I know what it's like to have peace when I'm in your presence. I know what it's like to understand that I'm loved and I'm not beating myself up anymore. When I look in the mirror, I'm not looking at what I look like. I'm looking at, wow, you love me. This is awesome. Wow. It says, and when your eyes are on this child. Now, this is to me literal. So when the eyes of God is on this child, because I am a child of the one true King.
That's right.
His eyes are on you all the time. Good, bad, ugly, indifferent, angry, happy, sad. He's looking. You know, the Word of God says that he is Jehovah the Lord. Jehovah means the Lord. Jehovah Shema. So that's why Jehovah's at the top, because Jehovah is attached, that dash, to every one of these Hebrew words. But each one of them is an attribute of God.
Yeah.
So Jehovah the Lord. The Lord is there. Jehovah Shema. The Lord is there. And over here, it says El Royai. It's supposed to say El Royai, but it says El Real. But it's supposed to be the other way. All this time, we've had this wrote on these walls for over 8 years, and it says Real. But nobody's ever come to me and said, hey, you always say El Royai, but hey, that's El. That's not what that says, because it doesn't matter what it looks like.
That's right.
Yeah. Boo-wah, right? It is what is behind it, the God who sees.
Yes, yes.
So he sees everything. I got like, they're called holy goosebumps all over me because God is in the room. Ah, I love it.
That's right.
So the thing is that he is looking at us. So when your eyes are on this child, your grace abounds. To me. His grace. You know, it's not that you earn anything. It's just his love for you and his love for me. So when his eyes are on us, he's looking at us. He's looking at you, Dave, as his child. Not what you can do for him, but just that you were created for him and you're stepping into that purpose.
Yes.
Now, it doesn't matter what yesterday was or last week or 6 months ago. It's the now. See, the motive of our hearts is what matters. Right? Ah, I'm giggly. So, So his grace abounds to me. So it's just, I don't know the meaning of this word, but to me, this is what it means to me. I'm wrapped in it. I'm bound to Jesus. He's got me, like when I said, all-consuming God consume me. That's what I see in this line of this song. Because if it wasn't for the grace of God, I would not be his child. If it wasn't for the grace of God, I wouldn't be the woman that I am, the mother that I am, the grandmother that I am, the wife that I am, the pastor that I am, the friend that I am, all those hats that I wear. But it's God's grace, and he sees me through his eyes of grace. And then it says, I want to take your word and shine it all around. So I now am saying to God, I just want to take your word and I just want to shine it all around. Can I tell you that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word is God? Can I tell you in the New Testament it says that the Word became flesh, which is Jesus. So if Jesus is the Word, like the Bible says, he is, right? We all agree? When we receive Christ as our Lord and Savior, and he enters into us, and now his beautiful spirit joins our spirit, and now we do bring light to the world. So the thing is that I want to take your word, his word is in us, and I want to shine it all around. So you see, we are shining, rather sometimes we want to be shining or not. Sometimes we don't want to be in the spotlight of other people on our bad days. But Christ can still shine through on our bad days just as much as he shines through on our happy days, on our joyful days. But I want you to know that you have the Word. The Word is within you. And you can carry it. And you can carry his presence. And you can carry his love. And you can carry it to the world, to the dark places, to the high places, to the low places. You can carry it wherever you go. He's there. So I just want to take your word and shine it all around. But first, help me just live, just to live it, Lord. But first, God, before I can take it out, help me to live it. Because you see, people are looking at your lives every day. Every day. And can I tell you, this is what I'm hearing. There are some people that are getting kicked around a little bit because of Christ, and I want you to stop looking at the people and what they say about you and just stay focused on what God is doing in and through you. You understand that? Because the world is going to kick you. The world sometimes is going to come against you, but you need to understand it came against the Lord. He was performing miracles. He was healing people. Arms were growing out. Limbs were healed. Diseases were gone. Leprosy that actually ate the flesh was healed, and their skin became white as snow. People still crucified him. People still crucified him. And God says, you know, take heart. If they do these things unto me, they're going to do these things unto you. So you can't base your salvation and your identity on how the world is going to treat you. You have to base it on what God says about you. Amen. So it says, but first help me just live it. Just to live it, Lord, help me. And he will. Because the spirit of you, the spirit of God within you is greater than he that is in the world. He is the comforter. He is the helper. And he will help us live for him. He will help us live above anger. He will help us live above judgment. He will help us live above a critical spirit. Many of us want to walk in those things. Not because we want to, but our flesh is. Because our flesh is just prickly. Our flesh is judgmental. Our flesh is selfish. And our flesh is jealous. And so you've got to keep that flesh crucified. That's why God cut away the flesh in circumcision. And the example of that is what's done to men or boys, babies, as infants. But it's actually an example. It's a spiritual example of what happens when we receive Christ. We're cutting away that flesh because that flesh is of no use to us now in the spirit realm. It will just get us in trouble. So it says, and when I'm doing well, this is key, when I'm doing well and walking in living for God, when I'm doing well, help me to never seek a crown. In other words, don't let the motive of your heart be wrong. Don't be serving God and serving other people so that they pat you on the back and so that you can just take all the glory that really belongs to God. God gives us crowns. There's crowns in the Word of God that we get for serving God. But the thing is, if you are serving God with the wrong motive and it is about you, then you're seeking His glory. See, when you just serve God, God is just serving through you. And the things that He does through us are supernatural. It's awesome. It's amazing. And I mean, you can be nice to people you couldn't. You can walk in forgiveness. You can sleep at night now because you're not tormented. You know, you can be victorious when most people are going to be victims. There's so much going on, but we have to remember that it is the love of God working through us that brings us those crowns of glory that we lay at His feet because we recognize that it's Him.
Yes.
That it's Him. Amen. It says, for my reward, is giving glory to you. So we give glory to the Lord. Amen. So then it goes, it's a very simple song. Then it goes back. Oh, Lord, you're beautiful. Your face, your presence is all I seek. When your eyes are on this child, your grace abounds to me. Now, if you would go to Psalm 63, all the Bibles are the same in here. I just want to read the scripture to you today. So in Psalm 63, it says, O Lord, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. So I've looked for you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory, because your loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise you. Thus I will bless you while I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul shall be satisfied as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise you with joyful lips. When I remember you on my bed, I meditate on you in the night watches, because you have been my help. Therefore, in the shadow of your wings, I will rejoice. My soul follows close behind you. Your right hand upholds me. But those who seek my life to destroy it shall go into the lower parts of the earth. They shall fall by the sword. They shall be a portion for jackals. But the king shall rejoice in God. Everyone who swears by him shall glory. But the mouths of those who speak lies shall be stopped. So I love the fact that we can see God early. I love that as we are in our beds at night, and we're alone, and these are when we're in our own thoughts, that we can go to a place, and if we can meditate on the good things of God, it will take you out of a bad place. Sometimes you have to speak out loud, because the thoughts that you're having a battle in your own mind, and when you speak out loud, whether you praise God, read the Word, get up and start, you know, I call it pacing and praying, you know, it just takes authority over anything that's negatively coming against your life. And I want you to know that God is the great I Am, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And He died that we would live. And He loves us. He loves us. But we're called into His presence. We're called to be after His face. We're called to be His children. I want you to know that you are His elect, like I said on Thursday. Chosen by God. You're holy and you're set apart. You're elected by God. He chose you. He loved us before we loved Him. He's the great I Am. And the plan that He has for us is awesome. We just have to let Him live. But see, the enemy that's after our soul tries to stop us, tries to get us focused on the negative, tries to get us just believing that we're never going to make it. We're going to miss the mark every time. And I'm here today to tell you, please stand up and fight the fight. The Word of God says, stand therefore when you can't stand anymore. In Ephesians 6, it says, stand therefore when you can't stand anymore, when you just can't do it anymore. God says, stand anyways. Stand. He says, having your loins girt about with truth. Just stand in the truth of God, no matter what that mountain looks like. Put on truth and let truth be your belt of honor. It says, put on the breastplate of righteousness. Righteousness, be righteous in Christ. He is already righteous in you. Just let him live. Put on the helmet of salvation. Protect your mind. Put the Word of God on. Put on the helmet of salvation. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts and in your minds. Put on. Cover your mind. Cover it. Put it on physically. Lord, I'm putting on the helmet of salvation today. Walk in the peace of the gospel. Put on. Put on those shoes of peace. Put on. Put that on and just walk every place you go. My husband, I pick on a lot. You know, when I said that, you know, he's the tortoise and I'm the hare. Dan walks with peace. He just does. His strut is peace. He's just peace. You know, when we started dating and I'm like, on the rock, you know, I'm like out there. And Dan just comes in. Everything's just peaceful. Everything's just peaceful, you know. And sometimes, you know, I have to get on his peace a little bit. And just kidding. But he is, you know, let that peace, let it be your strut. Let it be. Just, do you know what is in peace? Peace. Peace is like confidence. Peace is like, God, you've got this. God, I'm going to just keep walking. I don't know what's behind that door. I know my heart is right. My motive's right. I'm doing the best I can. I'm just going to trust you. I'm not going to be all freaking out all the time. I don't have to be. I'm walking in the peace of the gospel, the promises, like that song we sang. Do it again. Do it again. He's going to do it again. He's going to move that mountain for you. He's going to move that mountain for me. And, you know, the Word of God in Ephesians again says, you know, hey, pick up the shield of faith. Pick that shield of faith up. You got to pick it up. You know, it's down there. Pick up that shield of faith. Stand in faith. Even though it doesn't feel good, it doesn't look good, your faith is weak, pick that shield of faith up and stand behind that faith. Because the faith is the shield of faith is able to quench all the fiery darts from the enemy coming against you. It is able to quench them so they never penetrate your heart. So you need to have that shield of faith up and protect yourself because you're in a war. It's a spiritual war. And the Word of God says, hey, now listen, you also need to take the Word of God. My word is the sword. My word is the weapon. So when the devil comes and says, you did this, you can say, I'm forgiven by the blood of the Lamb. I'm going to overcome this. And this mess is going to turn into a message. And God has covered me and he's paid the price. And now I'm going to serve him. And I don't know how to do that yet, but this is my sword. This is my B-I-B-L-E. This is the book for me. I'm going to stand on the word. It's the word of God. It's my B-L-B-L-E. I am going to get in it, and I'm going to find some help in here because there's a lot of help in here. There's truth in here, and I need it. And I need to remember that God called me. I need to remember that I am reborn, that I'm rebirthed, and why. I need to know that God's given me a new heart. I'm not that old man. I did a couple things that I used to do, but that's not who I am. This is who I am. This is who God says I am. This is my sword. Amen. So we need the word. We need each other. We need to remember whose we are. Amen. We belong to the King. So Father, I thank you. We're going to sing Do It Again. I thank you, God, for what you are doing. I thank you for the mountains that are going to be removed today. And Lord, where the enemy's sitting on some shoulders in this room, we rebuke him now, taking authority, because the joy of the Lord is our strength, and we will be joyful in Jesus' name. Joy is in us because it is an attribute. It is a fruit of the Spirit. Yes. Yes. And we will stand in that.
Amen.
God, thank you for loving us. When we've been unlovable, you've been faithful. You don't let go of us. You're with us. And I thank you that Emmanuel is God with us, and he, Lord, is with us. You are with us. Thank you that we are just surrounded by your grace, your love. Thank you for another day. We have limbs and arms and fingers that work. Many of us. We can sing, we can talk, we have our minds. What we're facing, we'll get through. And it will be behind us. So I pray in the name of Jesus, what we're facing will not steal our joy. That we will seek you, that we will remember that you are beautiful, that you are doing what you want to do in our lives. God, we love you and praise you. In Jesus' name, all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. So before we sing this song, what is your name?
Brandon.
During worship, I just kept seeing your red shirt, you know, in my mind's eye. That's sometimes how God just illuminates a person to me is what they're wearing. And I just want to encourage you today. The Lord says to remind you and to tell you that you are not a throwback. And a lot of times we take on that identity, that we're just not worth saving. We're not worth loving. And that's an identity that you've been walking in for a while, I believe. And God says that that is not really truly your identity. And today he wants you to lay that identity down at the cross and step into the new identity that he has for you. He says you are called, you are set apart, that you're chosen by God. You are not a mistake. It doesn't matter how you came into the world. It doesn't matter how your mom and dad came together. It does not matter. What matters is that God called you into existence. And so I just want to encourage you today to get rid of that old man and step into a new man and just receive the joy of the Lord, because he's your strength. He says you've been beat down for a long time, not only by people in your atmosphere, but you started to beat yourself up and you started to, you know, crucify yourself mentally, and you just seem to be in such a rut. And God says that you've been brought here by him. Doesn't matter how you got here. He brought you here for you to hear the truth, because the truth is what's going to make you free. Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Okay, so, and then I just have to be obedient with you again, Dave. It's like, you know, you're really pushing, but the Lord just wants you to rest. You're doing everything that you know to do in your mind that you've been taught since you've been coming to River of Life, everything that you've talked about, you know, things that you've learned. But now God says, just rest. Just release it and just rest and let him take care of it. You have nothing to prove. You have nothing to prove. That's what he's saying. You have nothing to prove. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. God is good. God is good. And Pat, for you, Pat by the wall, because I have two Pats in here. Well, they're both by the wall. You, Pat. So for you, there is something in you new from God, and you might not even know that it's there, but it's a new activation by the Spirit of God. It's a new level with him. Sometimes your life and your actions and some of the stuff that you battle with, you feel like you just can't get there. You've tried everything, and you just can't get there. And God says, again, like Dave, rest. Let him do it. He says, it's in you, okay? But what happens is when you do something wrong and you know God is asking you not to do something like that or whatever it is, that it stops you from going forward because you feel like you're not worthy. You feel like, why am I even doing this, because I'm not there yet. Well, the thing is we are a process that we keep getting there. We're pressing on to get there. We won't get there until we get to heaven and we see glory. So God says just to allow the newness, the new seed, the new whatever he's doing in your life. Don't give up. Keep pressing. Let go of this back here. He says press on. Press on.
But you will never fail.
Fail us.
Yeah.
We just love you, Father. Just worship you, worship you, worship you.
Stand here so in awe how much you love us. Lord, it's my prayer that every person here would just understand the reality of that love and that it would go deeper in them today. Lord, we thank you that you will never leave us or forsake us. You're the same yesterday as you are today, as you will be tomorrow. And we can trust that we are safe with you. Lord, we just ask that you would go with us today and that we would be able to receive everything that you have given us today, Lord, and that it would change our lives, and therefore then we can change others.
Amen. 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 All right. Hallelujah.